Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jones. Basically, you start out with massive amounts of data. You say, how are we going to analyze this? Well, let's fire up a pivot table and see if we can solve this problem. Back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jellin. Got a voicemail a few days ago from Lisa. Lisa said, hey, I need to format every other row in this spreadsheet. It's, you know, my boss has this huge spreadsheet. He wants every other row formatted to make it easier to read. And while I was sitting there thinking about all of the different ways to solve this problem and trying to figure out which one would be the easiest to describe, I came up with this method initially. Now, we're in Excel 2007, but we're going to use a very easy Excel 2003 method. I'm going to choose all of the data in my data set, so that's control asterisk to choose all of the contiguous data there. And I'm going to use the old auto format dialog box. Now, that used to be on the format menu and then auto format. It was Alt+O to open format and then A to open auto format. They've taken this out of the Excel 2007 ribbon, but the old shortcut key will still get us there. So we hit Alt+O and then A, and we get the old auto format dialog box. Now, we end up with several different options here. And if we scroll down, you see this one here. List 1 is alternating rows of gray and white. List 2 is 2 rows of green, 2 rows of white. This is reminiscent of the old green bar formatting that we used to use back in the high-speed IBM line printer. 132 characters wide, and it would alternate green and white to make things easier to read. Okay, now before I choose this though, I don't want to just apply that whole format, because it's going to apply dark green to the headings. It's going to change my fonts. It's going to change my column widths. Really, it's going to do a lot more than I want it to do. So I click the options piece and I uncheck everything except for patterns. All I want to do is apply the patterns. And I'll choose list 2. We'll click OK. And very quickly, you can see that we've now set up an alternating green and white. First 2 rows in green, next 2 rows in white, next 2 rows in green, next 2 rows in white, and we're good to go. Fast way to go, not difficult to master at all. You know, just choose format, auto format, and you're good. Now, the one downside to this is that if we later insert a few rows, it's going to cause problems in the formatting. We'll talk about how to solve that Wednesday. This week, a couple of episodes from now, but a quick way to go. All right, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.
Well, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.